Hello students, welcome back. We'll continue with the chapter improvement and food resources, and today we are going to study about poultry farming. But before that, let us recapitulate animal husbandry, the first part, that is the cattle farming. Okay, the cattle can be reared for two reasons, either as a milk animal where we use the milk, that is the milch animal, or a draught animal, that is where we use them as for agriculture. For milch animal, we do breeding so that we get good amount of a progeny which is able to produce more amount of milk along with the disease resistant. This is done by crossing between a Indian breed and a foreign breed. Okay, and then we went on to the another aspects, like shelter is also important, food is also important, and disease control is also important for getting good amount of milk production. Today we will start with poultry farming. Now, what is poultry farming? Poultry is related with hens or chicks. Okay, you can add all the birds which you use as eating, like hen. I can add the cocks, I can add the ducks, pigeon. These all are the different things which are used as a poultry. Now again, poultry can be done for two things. You know that we eat even the egg and we eat even the meat. Okay, so the poultry farming can be again done for getting the egg, okay, or for getting the milk, fine, for getting the meat. Now if we are doing the poultry farming for getting the egg, we call such poultry as layers. Okay, what are layers? They lay the eggs, so they are called as layers. And the ones for which we do the poultry farming for meat, we call them as broilers. Okay, so if we are rearing a poultry for egg, we call this, they are as layers, and if we are rearing them for the meat, then we call them as the for the broilers. Okay, now let us see what is the difference between these two. I already told this will be used or reared for eggs and this will be for the meat. Okay, for laying of egg, they take about 20 weeks. Okay, a good healthy chick will lay about 20 weeks, after which it will start laying the eggs. And for broilers, it takes only 6 to 7 weeks for growth, and after that they are sent at the shops. Fine. The another thing, or another point of difference between the layers and boilers, are the next thing here, that they require more amount of vitamin and mineral rich diet. Okay, and the broilers require more amount of protein rich diet. We all know that the meat is mainly made up of protein, so it requires more amount of protein rich diet, so they are becoming more healthy. Protein rich, and two vitamins they require in excess, that is vitamin A and K. Okay, so these are the two vitamins they require in excess. So the first thing, they are used for eggs, they are used for meat. They will start laying the eggs after 20 weeks. They will start or become healthy after 6 to 7 weeks, and then they are sent for sale. Then they require vitamin and mineral rich diet, and they require protein, vitamin A and K. Okay. Now, if I want to get a good and healthy chick, again the only thing which I can do is breeding, right? And again, the breeding will be done between a Indian breed, that is the indigenous breed, like Asil. Asil is an Indian breed. A foreign breed like Leghorn. So you can have a cross between these two breed, and the hybrid which you get from the breeding process is always better than the simple one. Okay, it is always better than the simple one. Now there are few characteristics which you keep in mind while doing the hybridization or breeding, okay, to get the hybrid chick. The first thing, that the chick should lay more egg. Okay, or I can write poultry should lay more egg, and you should get good amount of chicks from it, both the things. The next thing is, the boilers are supposed to be dwarf. Okay, they should be dwarf so that why you need a boiler which is dropped, so that it takes less amount of food, okay, and gives more amount of meat. The boiler chicks are dropped, they'll take less amount of food, and once they grow they'll give you more amount of meat, except that you need that they are having good health, okay. They should have a good health. Next one, they should be able to survive in different climatic condition, because generally this poultry dies if it is too much hot temperature, if the temperature goes too much low. So they should be able to survive in extreme temperature. And the last one, the last characteristics is that they should be able to give me more amount of egg as well as chick with cheaper resources as food, okay? Cheaper resources as food. Like you can use the husk of the wheat and the paddy over here also as the food, because it contains more amount of fiber and proteins, okay? For proteins you can use the pulses over here. So the cheaper resources can be used for the same breeds. Okay, whatever hybrid which I have got, so the cheaper resources they should be able to eat and give me more amount of eggs, as well as the quality of the chick should be good. Okay, here should lay more egg, good amount of chick. You can even write quality over here. Why quality? Because when I am talking about a chick, when I am using it as a boiler, okay, I need good healthy ones. Fine. So these are the different characteristics for which you do poultry farming, and poultry farming can be done for layers as well as boilers. Now let us go to the next one. Once we do breeding, the next thing is we need to give them food, okay. Again over here I already discussed there is different food requirement. If I am having layers or egg laying poultry, then I need to give them vitamin and mineral rich diet, and if I want to rear the boilers, then I need to give them protein, vitamin A and K rich diet, okay. Going to the shelter. Now the shelter of these two also differs. I'll write over here in the point of difference only. If I am rearing a egg or a layerer, okay, poultry for egg or a layerer, then what is the major thing is they require well ventilated and spacious area. Okay. Why spacious area? Because they are going to lay eggs. It should not happen that you have filled in too much amount of chick in a proper cage. So what will happen? The eggs will break. Okay. So they require well ventilated, sunlight should be proper, air should be proper, and they require a spacious area. Whereas boilers do not require that much spacious area, but they require control of temperature. Okay. Because the temperature brings about too many changes in the size of the chick. So the cage in which, or the place in which you are keeping the broilers, it should have a controlled temperature so that the broilers can grow very fast. You see over here there is a difference. Here only 20 weeks is there for getting the egg, so it is a long time. And if I see over here, there is only 6 to 7 weeks in which I need the broilers to get ready. So I need to keep the temperature in check. Okay, so this is about the shelter. Food we already discussed. For the egg layers, vitamin and minerals, and for the meat or the broilers, I require protein, vitamin A and K. Now there is only one way by which you can take care of the health of the chicks, that is vaccination. Okay, the chicks at the smaller age only they are vaccinated, so they do not get any disease. Apart from that, you need to fumigate the place where you are keeping the chicks so that any pest, okay, or lice or ticks which are there, they will die. You cannot comb the hairs over here because they do not have hairs, they have feathers. Okay, so you fumigate the area, okay, and vaccinate them properly. So this is about poultry farming. Okay, poultry farming can be done for two things, either for egg or meat. If I am doing for egg, I called as layers, and if I am doing for the meat, I called as boilers. Now the egg ones, okay, the poultry which are reared for eggs are ready by 20 weeks, and boiler should be ready by 6 to 7 weeks. The food requirement for the egg layers are what? Vitamin and minerals rich diet, and for boilers you have protein, vitamin A and vitamin K rich diet. The shelter should over here should be well ventilated and spacious. Over here you require not very big shelter, but you require proper control of temperature so that they can grow fast. Okay, and these are the characteristics for which you can do the breeding. The poultry should lay more eggs and give good amount and quality of chicks. The boiler should be dwarf so that they eat less and you get more amount of meat. Chicks should have good health. They should be able to survive in extreme temperature or climatic condition, and they should be able to survive on cheaper resources. With this, we finish with the poultry farming, and in the next lecture, we'll start with the fish farming. Thank you.
Hope this video increased your knowledge. For more such videos and a completely free educational content, log on to www.epathshala.org or visit our ePathshala YouTube channel. We have each and every question solved for maths, physics, chemistry and biology. So subscribe our channel, share with your friends, like our Facebook page and follow our Twitter handle for regular updates and important educational tips, and also win ePathshala goodies. So what are you waiting for? Subscribe this channel and enjoy the freedom of education.